Hello people, this is SelfTuts and we are continuing our series on understanding the concept of Express, and in this video we'll see how to install Express. So before installing Express, we must satisfy some prerequisites, and those are Node.js must be installed in your system, and if you want to check that if Node.js is present or not, then you need to fire the command node --version. You also have to have npm in your system, which is a node package manager. So when you install Node.js, then by default npm or the node package manager is installed in your system. So to see if npm is present in your system or not, you need to check npm --version. So installing Node.js, you can go to the Node.js website and see how to install based on your system, like it is Windows, Mac or Linux. So these two things must be present before installing Express. Now, how to install Express? So before installing Express, you need to create a npm project. So you need to initialize a project where you want to install your Express. So we'll go to our Linux box, that is which I'm using, and if I do pwd, which is present working directory, then it will say this is the path of my working directory and I'm inside my understanding Express concepts folder. So I'll create a project inside it, and I'll say npm init. So this will ask me few questions like what is the name. So I'll take everything for default. The name is this, the version is this, and if you need to provide some descriptions, you may. The entry point is index.js. If there's a test command, if there's a git repository, if you want to provide some keyword, I'll provide my author as SelfTuts and license as ISC. So this is the basic information about my current project, that is understanding Express concept project. So it will ask me that is this right. So this says that it is about to write a file package.json inside my pwd or the present working directory folder. So I'll do a clear so that it is clearly visible, and if I do ls, then it will say me I can see that a new file has been created and the name of that file is called package.json. So package.json is very important file inside any node project. So everything about your node project is written inside this package.json file, like what is the name of the project, what are the modules on which my project is depending, like what are the dependencies, what are the development dependencies, which Git repository it is pointing. So currently if I'll see my package.json file, then it will show me the basic information which I have entered previously, which is the name, version, description. Currently it doesn't provide any dependencies or development dependencies section, but we'll see after a few minutes that when I install Express, then my dependencies section is created. So what I'll do, I'll go to my slide and I'll see that how to install Express. So we'll say npm install Express --save. So what it does, it asks my node package manager to install Express module from npm server, and this --save flag is to write the name of the Express package or Express module and the version which is getting installed inside my package.json file. So we'll just see it in a few minutes, and I'll say npm install Express --save. So previously you have seen that in my package.json file there was no dependencies or development dependencies section. Now I'll try to install it. So what it will do, it will go to the npm server and it will try to install the Express module. So depending on the speed, it will take very less time. So here it shows that what are the different packages or different modules which it has installed. So I have installed only Express, but Express internally depends on another modules like cookies, content type, content disposition, array flatten. So what npm does, npm downloads the Express module and also downloads the dependencies which are related for that Express module. So now if I'll see my package.json file, you can see that a dependency section has been created, and inside the dependencies the name of the module that is Express is present here, and what is the version of that module, or the version of Express module, that is 4.15.4, which I'm using now, which I have installed, is listed on here. So what is the importance of this package.json file? So when you create a new project, then after some time you will use a versioning system like Git to maintain your project, and after some time you will push this project on a remote repository. So anyone can clone that repository and fire the command npm install. So by firing the command npm install, npm will read this package.json file and it will see what are the dependencies present, and it will download that dependencies automatically. So you need to understand that package.json file is the most important file inside my Node project. So I'll quit this file, and you can see now a node modules folder has been created inside which my Express module will be present. So I'll go inside my node module, and if I type Express, then you can see that Express folder is present. Or simply I'll go inside my node module, and if I do a ls, then you can see that my Express module is present here. So this was all about how to install Express in your project, and you can just see the commands, that a prerequisite of Node.js is there and a prerequisite of npm is there. How to check that these are correctly installed? You need to fire node minus minus version, npm minus minus version. Then you need to initialize a project, and then you need to install Express. So this was all about installing Express. If you like my channel, please subscribe to it, and if you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Thank you.